season is supposedly a really far cry from the book. Why did you guys vary so much?
You know, the story kind of needs to go where the story's going to go, and I mean, we were never beholden to the book, ever. I feel like I said those very same words maybe here a year or two ago. No, yeah. I mean, it's been, for me, it's more fun to go far afield, but that's not the goal either. It's just to sort of use the books, take what we can, and then, you know, take whatever input we're getting from the actors, for example, the talent and stuff, and see what's working and just build on that.
When you started pitching that it was going to be a 5-season series, I know that that's been the word for a while, but did you know that it was always going to expand beyond the books and everything?
Well, I knew, there's never been any, like, set number of seasons, and nor were we ever like one book equals one season. So we always thought that there'd be some overlap and some expansion. So no, I wouldn't look for books to line up with the seasons at all. I guess what I'm saying is there's a story plan, but there's no scheduling season.
Did Guillermo del Toro have a? Does he have a role in this, or as it gets further away from the books, is he consciously stepping away more to let the show run its own way?
I wouldn't say he's stepping away at all, no. I mean, right now he's prepping a movie that shoots next month. He's still very much involved. He's just got so many other projects. And the show is, you know, it's definitely up on its feet, and we're running, too. So it's not that he's not needed. He's completely welcome, and he has a lot of input. But, you know, there's a foundation established that we're, you know, doing.
Is there a character that, as the writer of the book and as the TV show progresses, you've actually come to like more in the TV show than you did when you were writing it in the book?
It's hard to really say. Like, I always liked Quinlan, but, like, season 3, Quinlan is, it's not like he's my favorite character, but he is such a unique character in the show, obviously. So it's something that's, I feel like, it's even popping even more than it did in the books. Rupert, the actor, is fantastic, too, so he brings a lot to it. So stuff like that, it's a great sort of treat, having been there way back before the beginning, to see it now, you know, really flourishing, to see an actor take on a part that I thought was great and make it even greater.
Have you found that you're writing yourself more for the actors now than you did for the characters at the beginning?
A little bit of both. I mean, we definitely get a lot of input from the actors, which is great. They're all really involved and they're really sort of committed to their characters. Now, if they were coming up with horrible ideas, that could be a really bad situation. Luckily, everyone's really contributing. And so, no, it's great. We really want to play to people's strengths. We also want to challenge people and take them out of their comfort zone, too. And they rise to those challenges, too.
Has any performance affected the way you not just write for the actor, but how you write the character in a sense, like you change the character's trajectory based on how the actor is playing?
I'm trying to think of a specific. I'm sure that has happened, but not in a major way. I mean, I remember going back to the first couple of episodes with Richard Sammel with iCourse, we were just like, this is fantastic, we can do so much with him, and so it just opens up opportunities for us. So things like that, you're always looking to, you know, to use that stuff to the best of advantage. It's a really great, when you see something working, you just want to throw more and more and more, and it's completely open.
Another character that kind of has been changed up is Palmer.
Yep.
From the books. Any hints of what we can expect from him? I kind of had sympathy for him at the end of the last season.
As good, I mean, as you should. Yeah, as season 3 starts, he's really, you know, he's been dealt a serious blow, for sure. And he's really back on his heels. So I think you're going to see him strike up a very surprising, unexpected alliance, you know, with other characters. Then there's a back and forth too about, you know, how far it's going to go. But it's been really great. Jonathan's fantastic, and he really rises to the occasion in season 3. It's really difficult to talk about any part of the season because I feel like there's, there's big stuff happening in every episode. So it's tough to talk too much ahead. But yeah, big things are in store for me.
Do you think this season is actually darker in tone than the previous seasons, or how would you describe
honestly,
it?
I'm going to say, I mean, in a weird way, I don't think it's darker. It's just so much more expansive. I really do. It's great to be able to come here and say we're we're getting better every season, and I truly feel that. Season 3 is really good. So I don't know if it's darker. I mean, there are dark things in it, as there have been from the first minute of the show. So it's hard to get any real darker. But no, I feel like actually, in my mind, there's a little bit of, I don't know, there's a little bit of looseness in this season. And we've opened up the world a little more. You're really going to hopefully get a sense of what it's like to, you know, to be living in this plague that the show takes place.
Do you feel you've ramped up the action in the fights a little more? I've just seen the first episode. I was only able to watch the first episode, and it felt like there was a lot more.
A lot more, yeah, for sure. We've going from this season, we're doing 10 episodes. So we had, I mean, it's not like we had the same amount of production time. We had less, but we were able to really sort of, you know, press and throw as much, you know, into every episode as possible. So yeah, I think there's more startling effects, definitely more action, because there's more story action that needs to be